The name of a Steeler great is changing the medical world tonight. Mike Webster's impact on the field can't compare to his impact now. Channel 4 Action News anchor Michelle Wright tells us why the medical community wants to rename the condition that took his life the Mike Webster disease.
We knew him as Iron Mike. Number 52 went into the Football Hall of Fame as one of the greatest centers to ever play the game. But what we couldn't see on the field was what was happening underneath his helmet to his brain. So let me show you. This is actual damage that Mike Webster's brain received. He was the first modern athlete to be diagnosed with repetitive brain trauma, a condition that would eventually take his life. Iron Mike won 4 Super Bowls in the 70s, a powerful force whose name is now in the Football Hall of Fame. But his name will go far beyond that.
From a son to, you know, kind of see that my dad's legacy is going to carry on in that way, it's an honor to be associated with it.
The disease that took his life will now bear his name, but the honor comes with great tragedy. Mike Webster struggled in his later years with drugs, homelessness, dementia. He was only 50 when he died. The cause of death is officially listed as coronary heart disease, but when the medical examiner took a microscopic look at his brain, he was stunned at the injuries he saw and named the condition chronic traumatic encephalopathy. Now they want to rename it the Mike Webster disease.
He was the first modern athlete so diagnosed. He was certainly a great player on perhaps football's greatest team and was the cornerstone of the offensive line and the team and the team spirit, I believe.
Neurosurgeon Dr. Julian Bale showed me an example of an injured brain. The dark spots are tau protein. They're like sludge that won't allow the cells to work properly, the result of repetitive concussions. Mike Webster's son now understands what happened to his father, and he works with families dealing with what he went through.
The number one goal for me is always making sure no other family ends up our way.
As a brain gets rattled inside the skull, it can easily be damaged, and the more damage without allowing it time to heal is very dangerous. Dr. Bale says football is a safe game for kids and they should enjoy it, but he also thinks there needs to be some fundamental changes to the game, especially in the NFL, where the speed of the game is increasing.
I don't think the human brain long term can stand this without risk unless we begin to eliminate unnecessary contact to the head. I believe we should eliminate contact in practice. I think that we should look at getting linemen out of the three-point stance so that they can avoid this obligatory or mandatory or gratuitous contact on every play.
Garrett says that's what his father would want for future players and hopes his dad is proud of the work being done in his name.
He would be proud for the simple fact of how we're helping people. I know that when my dad was alive and he played in the 70s, you know, he really made a real effort to help children and do charitable work and stuff like that. I would like to think he's proud of what I'm doing.
Dr. Bale says there is one good thing. He's been a sideline physician for some 21 years now, and he says just over the last couple of years, players are asking him questions about the impact to their brain. He says education is making a big difference. Michelle Wright, Channel 4 Action News.
Now, if you or your child is playing a sport, here are some signs of a concussion: headache, memory problems, difficulty with concentration or classwork, vision or balance problems. Dr. Bale says anybody diagnosed should stay out of the game until the brain heals. That's so important because getting a second concussion before then puts a person most at risk for permanent damage.